I think this is going to be another one where those guys come in here and just trade Roberto.
I agree with you. Anytime Josh Collins fights, it's going to be a good night.
You see mutual respect between these guys. They know a lot about each other. They know each other's tendencies. So I'm excited to see who's going to be smart and land a good shot, or who's going to go in there and start just swinging haymakers.
All righty, we got our next fight ready to go, scheduled for 3 2-minute rounds. These gentlemen weighed in at 215 pounds in anticipation of tonight's fight. It is K1 Rules Kickboxing, sponsored by Easy On Bobber in the blue corner. Coming to us out of Columbia, South Carolina, fighting and training at Spartan Academy, he is 2-1, Neil Gray. And in the red corner, coming to us out of Guyton, Georgia, fighting and training at Ike's Box MMA. He's 4-3 in MMA, 3-3 in kickboxing. Welcome a crowd favorite, Josh Collins.
Most definitely a crowd favorite out here. You can hear the people in the back end and the backside.
Yes, screaming here. Josh Collins, a nice conflict MMA veteran on the MMA side and the kickboxing side. I was here for the last fight. It was fireworks. They were dropping bombs. All right. Touch of the gloves. Neil starting out with a couple double jabs. Feeling out of the range.
Neil staying staying long with that jab. Oh, here comes that low kick.
Nice low driving low kick. Head, body, nice body shot by Collins.
It's good. Collins is prepping that right hand to drop it hard. He's keeping it low, but if he lands with it, he's going to come in with a lot of power from that waist area.
Yeah, he looks like a little bit like Dan Henderson, having that right hand ready to throw it.
Yeah, that comes with consequences, though. You can't just leave it down there hanging like this. At this range, I think he's fine. He just needs to be prepped for a head kick. Yeah. Ooh, good spinning back kick.
Josh is being the aggressor right now. Neil looks like he's just trying to pick his shots.
Yeah, he's definitely looking for that counter. He was right, you know. If he gets too excited, Neil's going to make him pay.
Yeah, and that's the one he told me, one of his keys to victory, is he didn't want to get too excited, and he looks like he's excited right now. You know, when that case door closes, everything goes out the window.
Yeah, it's definitely a lot harder to think in there. Collins is maintaining his breathing very well.
They both are. Both of them are trying to pick their shots. Collins is definitely the aggressor right now.
Ooh, big winging right.
Ooh, nice Superman punch. Does not land. Neil makes him pay for it. A nice overhand right by Neil. Ooh, nice duck under to the body by Neil.
Again to the body. Remember the body.
Move. Another spinning back kick by Collins.
Neil's corner is calling for that body shot. There. Crazy thing about these big boys is it's very easy to close that distance from across that cage. Once he rushes, he can find himself up against the cage very, very fast.
And they both pack a lot of power. Roberto, how would you score that round?
Me personally, I think I was I would favor that towards Josh Collins. He stayed on the outside, landed heavy shots, threw some kicks. Those spinning heel kicks definitely looked pretty good and landed.
Yeah, he was definitely the aggressor there, landing more. Neil looked like he was kind of picking his shots, but he didn't really throw much. I don't know if he's trying to set up his timing or he's trying to figure out his distance. Wasn't really too aggressive. Collins was more the aggressive one. Landed a couple good spinning back kicks. Interested to see how this next round goes. While we have a break, guys, I do want to give a shout out to Roberto coming off his nice BKFC victory. Roberto, it was an awesome fight. First round TKO. You couldn't have done anything better. Super proud of you, sir.
Thank you. Appreciate it. I'm really enjoying the bare knuckle come up so far. Looking to get back in the sports circle pretty soon.
Well, I can't wait to see you there. I'll be there for sure. All right, start of the next round. Touch of the gloves. see if Neil comes a little more aggressive or he continues to try to counter. Ooh, nice back kick, spinning back kick of Neil himself.
There we go. It was a side kick.
Side kick,
he didn't spin you there, but it same concept where the power comes from. Both of them are doing a pretty good job of gauging distance here. Long jabs. That's what you want to see here.
It looks like Neil's really trying to set up that power shot. Another spinning back kick by Collins.
Ooh, nice. That's a good counter, right? So an interesting thing to note here is that Josh Collins is a orthodox fighter and Neil is a southpaw. So it's very easy for those both of these guys get met with a head kick.
Yeah.
Especially with how low their lead hands, their rear hands are. Right. You see Josh Collins dropping it down to the chest, and so does Neil. Neil has it down there too. So a head kick can call an early night for both of these gentlemen. It's open for both.
Collins is doing great with that spinning kick, but I'd like
to jump off the cage.
A little Anthony Pettis here. I'd like to see Neil let his hands loose a little bit more.
I'm just happy he didn't jump off our cage.
That could have been a bad night for us, my friend. Nice body kick shot.
So that's a risky run when you have two people fighting orthodox and southpaw here. The body shots are open. For that rear kick. There he goes again.
Another kick, yes. There it is. Collins has got to make it. Ooh, nice overhead miss.
Made him pay.
I'll say this. I expected more, I think, because the last time in the TKO, they're a little bit cautious because they both know the power that they both carry. I would like to see a little bit more. Neil picked it up towards the end of the round.
They're definitely respecting each other's power right now.
And when they do throw, it's a lot of overhands, a lot of power shots.
A very good setup that we can see here is Neil keeps carrying in these body shots from the rear and then changes it up and goes to the head. He might be able to get a head kick KO.
What do you feel about Josh's spinning back kick? He's throwing it a lot. He's landing it. But I feel like he could use that to set something else up or either set up the back kick a little bit more.
Well, I mean, if it's landing and he moves his opponent with it, it's a pretty good shot to keep doing. You know, it's going to wear down the body. And then he can do a fake and you know, move from there, maybe throw some hands. I would love to see Josh Collins get inside a little bit more, maybe work his body.
Yeah, it seems like they're being a little bit reserved this fight. Last time, those two were throwing bombs, haymakers back and forth. Now it seems they're both being very cautious.
Here comes that body kick.
Now, he set up to the head. Very nice spinning back kick to the head, landed flush.
Josh Collins looks very comfortable. I've got this round 1-1 right now.
I agree.
Now, here he comes. Neil Gray keeps throwing that body kick. Hopefully we'd see him switch it up and then go high.
This is where we wanted to see more action. Now Neil's walking it down. Collins against the cage, throwing nice overhand.
Returned by Collins. Uppercut.
Nice uppercut.
This is the barn burner we were expecting to see, ladies and gentlemen.
Yeah, this is what we thought we were going to see rounds 1 and 2. These guys are just throwing caution to the wind. A lot of overhands. Nice. Another spinning back kick by Collins.
That's what you want to do in this kind of round. You don't want to leave it up to the judges. Right now, I have it scored 1-1. You've got to do something to steal this round heavy.
You got to say, hey, this was my fight. It's got to be this round. They need a 10-8 round here. I think Collins needs to go back to the head with that spinning kick. Nice body shot. Nice overhand.
Collins covering high.
Now they're going back to being cautious again. Nice jab by Neil.
I think Collins is going to come in with a rear kick here soon.
Collins is walking him down. But he walks him down.
He's going to try to knock him out with that right. He's charging it up.
He's knocking him down, but he hasn't thrown it yet. Hopefully he does. So they got to do something to win the round.
10 seconds.
They gotta go. They gotta go. Neil saying, let's go. There we go. This is what we wanted to see, folks. It's true sportsmanship right there, guys. From two guys that have gone at it before. Both of them seem a little bit of cautious there. That is
rough. Honestly, I would even score that round. I would call this a draw.
I couldn't
put him back
more.
In there.
I honestly don't see either one dominantly winning. I would have to call it a draw too. I'm curious to see how the judges scored that one. I would call it a draw. I couldn't agree more with your assessment. True sportsmanship, true friendship from two veterans. They had some flashes right there at the end where they threw, and then they got a little cautious and went back to throwing. So, very interesting fight. Not what we were expecting, but overall still a good fight. Two warriors going at it, putting their bodies on the line. Great job by Josh Collins and Neil Gray.
All right, we have a decision of our judges in this fight. How about a round of applause for Neil Gray and Josh Collins before we announce it? K1 Rules
I'm holding on to my seat
sponsored
here,
by Easy On Bobber. See, I got that again in again for you. There you go. All right, so
fourth
unanimous
round.
Decision in favor of, in the blue corner, Neil Gray.
Very interesting
unanimous
call.
Winner.
I had that in a split. If anything, I don't know about unanimous. What is your opinion on that one?
I had it right down the middle. If I was judging, I would have given it a draw.
Yeah, I agree with you, Roberto. I think that's a good call. I think a majority draw would have been good. But, you know, unanimous, it caught me off guard. I could see Neil that last round taking it, maybe the second. For sure that first round, I had Collins.